Hello, once again, this is Phil Fernandez. I'm the pastor of Trinity Bible Fellowship. I had the Doctor of Ministry program in apologetics for Veritas International University, and I teach Bible and philosophy and world religions at the Christian High School, Cross Point High School in Bremerton, Washington. And today I'd like to give a little talk about what I call the who and the how. The who and the how, and I'm going to deal with the who and the how when it comes to creation, you know, how we got here, but also epistemology, how we know, knowledge, okay? And when it comes to creation, the who and the how, the Christians don't have to know. We don't have to, you know, it's like, well, how do we get here? I mean, how could something come into existence out of nothing? Well, Christians don't have to know the how because we know the who. We believe that an infinitely powerful, eternal creator God created the universe. So how did God create everything else that exists out of nothing? I don't know. He's infinite. He knows. I don't know. We don't have to know the how because we know the who. But the evolutionists have come on the scene and they say, you know what? We don't have to believe in the who anymore, the creator, because now we figured out the how. Okay, well then, Mr. Atheist, evolutionist, how do we get here? Well, evolution. Well, so everything got here by evolution. That's how we got here. What does evolution mean? How did evolution occur? What's the mechanism through which evolution occurred? So, well, we're not really sure. However, it was probably mutations. No, mutations only garble the already existing genetic code. If the genetic code was something like the 26 letters of our alphabet, it wouldn't add a 27th or 28th letter. You'd lose a few letters or it would garble the order, but you get no new information. And to go from simple things to complex things, you need added information. You need intelligent intervention. So they say, okay, well, maybe it wasn't mutations, but we don't know how evolution occurred, but it occurred. Well, wait a minute. Then you really don't know the how. Evolution is just a word. You got a question mark, how we got here, because you reject the who, the creator. Well, then how do we get here? Well, evolution. Well, evolution just covers the question mark, but until you know how evolution occurred, it really doesn't solve your problem. It's still a question mark. And so atheists claim we don't have to believe in the who, God, because we know the how, evolution. But then they admit they don't know how exactly evolution occurred, so they don't know the how. So since you evolutionists don't know the how, I suggest you return to the who. Okay? And so we Christians don't have to know the how God did it, because we know the who. The infinite creator created a finite universe out of nothing. But it's the same way with epistemology, knowledge. When I debated the America's leading philosophical atheist back in 1997, the late Dr. Michael Martin, philosophy professor at Boston University, in his book, Atheism, A Philosophical Justification, his chapter on epistemology, how man can know and what man knows, he concludes the chapter with the fact that secular philosophers, non-Christian philosophers, have never really come to agreement on how man knows. So then he says, okay, well, then I just need to move on from there and start figuring out, does God exist and all? And it's like, nah, in my debate with him, I said, no. Until you figure out how man can know, you can't move on because you reject the who. You see, Christians don't have to know how. We don't have to know the how of how we know, okay, in our epistemology. Because we know the who. The who, the infinite knower, created finite, limited knowers in his image so that we could know and have knowledge. So I don't have to come up with it. There's some really good Christian theories of knowledge, whether it's Augustine's illumination doctrine or Thomas Aquinas's view. There's some really good Christian theories of knowledge, but the fact is we don't have to know how man knows because we know the who. We don't need the how, we got the who. An infinite knower created us finite knowers in his image so that we can know. But if you reject the infinite knower, then you have to explain how man can know. And if reason with a small r, like C.S. Lewis argued, if reason with a small r didn't come from reason with a capital R, then we have no basis from which to trust in what we think our reason is telling us. So if reason had non-rational causes, how do we even know that it works? And so atheists have never explained how man can know. And they shouldn't even move on in their philosophies, their philosophical systems, their worldviews, until they figure out how man can know. The Christian doesn't even have to know the how, because we know the who. How does man know? Because we were created by the infinite who, the infinite knower. How did we get here? We don't have to know how everything was created, all the universe was created out of nothing, because we know the who, the infinite creator created the universe and has the ability to do so. So the who and the how, because Christians know the who, we don't have to know how everything came into existence out of nothing, how God did it. We don't have to know how man knows, because we know the who. The infinite knower created us in his image, and the infinite creator had the ability to create this vast universe out of absolutely nothing. So that's my little talk on the who and the how. This is Pastor Phil Fernandez, Trinity Bible Fellowship. You can reach us through snail mail, P.O. Box 3264, Bremerton, Washington, 98310. That's P.O. Box 3264, Bremerton, Washington, 98310. Please subscribe to The Phil Fernandez Show. You can visit our website, Phil Fernandez, Fernandez with an S, philfernandez.org, or sermonaudio.com/IBD. But thank you for all your support and your prayers. God bless you and be safe.